We're all very soft-spoken.
First of all, I wanted to thank you for your translation and Sextus and our Apollo Theater. Thank you for having us here. It was such a great experience for me because I never worked like this. The result is very successful. I've been very happy to be translated by Jan and Jana. Thanks to them too. We are going to read first Turkish and then English. The first poem is Bu bir alsa, bir alsa bu. I never remember my poems actually. From the beginning, my poetry is very political. Even though I don't use political terminology or vocabulary, but still it's very political. But one of my recent book called The Last Mountain, that was more political, as I know. And because I describe poetry always like an elegy or a lament, for me it's a kind of cosmic feeling that we had through our ancestors' history also. There is sorrow, there is history behind it, there is big tragedies. All my poetry is around that actually, but this one is more. Bir alsa bu. All mayandı ülkeden söz ediyorlar. All mayandinden, kardeşlikten. Konuşma yok, yok kelimeler. Anlaşılmak içinse yeryüzü, kim ölümü anlatacak? Dağların aldığı nefesi, çöken karanlığı, kim anlatacak? Bir çocuğun rüyasında büyüyenleri kim? Kuşların kanatları eski bir masaldan bana doğru çırpınıyor. Eski kadınların anlattığı, tenin taşa yakınlığı. Belli ki bir avcıyım ben. Karanlık çöktüğünde, dağların ötesinde kimi ansam bakıyor bana acıyla. Bu bir ağıtsa ağlamak henüz başlamadı.
If this is a lament, they speak of a land that never was, a non-existent tongue. There is no utterance, no words. If we're put on earth to understand each other, who can make sense of death? Explain how the mountains stole breath, or translate the darkness that has fallen? Who can say what burgeons in a child's dream? Flapping out of an ancient tale, birds' wings bear down on me, and skins akin to stone, as the old women used to say. When darkness falls beyond the mountains, the people I remember look to me in pain. My words are elegy. If this is a lament, we haven't even begun to cry.
My early poems were more dark, I think. As I'm getting old, my poetry becomes more like kind of not that heavy on me. I don't know how you feel. This is one of the old ones. Rengi sileri. Çürümüş, donuk kalbimde bu toprakların gözleri gördüm. Herkes sesiyle vardı ve duruşuyla gövdesinin. Bir insanı en iyi seçirken tanırız. Kalbimizi birlikte çürütürken, ağırlaşan gözlerimiz gece uyandırır. Mezar gibidir avlulu evler, çocukluk bir uykudur, uzun sürer. Ve dokunmak için bir arzu sürükler bizi ölüme. Ben kendimi sınadığım her gövdede, ben kendimi bıraktığım her şehirde, içime aldığım gövünü ülkelerin ve boşluğunu görünce kalbimin gitmeli dedim. Çürümüş tören gizleri içinde askıda salınan kökler, biz denize düşürsek de ateşi o hep yanar. Issızlık bahşeder, karanlığa yanar. Tarih bir yanılgı olabilir diyor şair. İnsan bir yanılgıdır diyor Tanrı. Çok sonra, bu toprakların kalbi kadar sürmüştür sonra da, insan bir yanılgıdır diyor Tanrı ve düzeltmek için varım ama geciktim. Ölü kızıl suyun dalgası, gece yürünen yol ve yolcuların dağıldığı zavallı yeryüzü. Salınan beyaz ketenler, tören giysileri ve bir koşu için gerekli tek şey atın yelesidir. Ast olan, şimdi de burada çürüyüp kaldık. Tanrı görmesin harflerimi. İnsan bir hata arıyor durmadan ve hatasını düzeltmek için acı veriyor, sadece acı.
Ceremonial groups. In the cold, dead heart of a lamb, I saw their eyes. Everyone was there with their own stance and voice. We know each other best when we make love together. Our hearts decay. Our bodies growing heavy wake us in the night. Houses with courtyards are like graves. Childhood is a slumber. It lasts a long time. And the desire to touch pulls us towards death. I tried myself in every body, lost myself in every city, took each country's sky to heart, and when I saw the emptiness of my heart, that's enough, I said. Inside decaying ceremonial robes, roots swaying on the hanger. Even doused in the sea, this fire will burn forever. It beats out light in the darkness. It burns on. Perhaps history is a mistake, the poet says. Humankind is a mistake, says God. The future corrupt as the heart of the lamb. Humans are a mistake, says God. I've come to put things right. Too late. Red tide of the dead, the road taken at night, and the poorer where pilgrims scatter, warm shrouds sweeping, ceremonial robes. To flee beneath the horse's mane, this is the truth left here. May God not read my words. Keep saying humankind was a mistake. And correcting himself brings sorrow. Nothing but sorrow.
This poem called How Human Can Die, Ajimut Hanır. Actually, this is one of the stories I heard from my mom, my mother. They used to live in kind of very spiritual, let's say shamanistic atmosphere. And trees are very important in our culture. In our cemetery, when we enter the cemetery, there is a holy oak tree. We kiss it to show our respect and our love towards that and the living one. And this tree story was told by my mother, and she said when we were young in the highland to meet with our loving one, we were going to a place. Each of us has a tree, and we were waiting there. We were waiting for someone to come and choose us. That was a kind of mythologic ritual for them. It's a short poem. I try to describe my tree and impossible love for this image. Since I'm living in London, I'm doing a project with the refugee kids for young people. And I asked them, they like this poem a lot, and I asked them, what would be your tree? And they come up with a very, very nice stories from Aleppo, from Afghanistan, from Africa. It's a nice play for us. Yeah. Her kadın kendi ağacını tanır. Sana geldiğinde kanatlarımı siyah taşlarla örülmüş o ıssız şehrin üzerinde açacak, bulduğum bir ağacın dallarına tüneyecek ve acıyla bağıracaktım. Her kadın kendi ağacını tanır. Uçtum o gece, karanlığın girmeye korktuğu şehri geçtim. Gölge olmayınca ruh yalnızdı.
Every woman knows her own tree. When I looked for you, I spread my wings over the city built of black abandoned stones, found a tree and perched on its boughs and shrieked with pain. Every woman knows her own tree. That night, I crossed a city so black that darkness feared to enter it. My soul was lonely without its shadow.
Buldum. O gölde buzlarla çevrilmiş binlerce yıldır ölmüştüm. Uyandırdım. Uyandım ve yanmış bir ormanın sisinde buldum uykumu. Geceye yapıştı gölden. Bir buzulun derin ışığından tene akan beyazlık hatırlattı. O gölde yürüdün sen.
Glacier. Dipped the world a thousand years in a lake immured in ice. You woke me up. Mist. I found I'd been sleeping in a charred forest. My body clung to night. White light from the depth of the glacier floods into my skin. Reminds me, you walked on that lake, leaving your tracks, skin, scars.
İki rüyada büyümek. Sen uykudan söz ederken, iki rüyada büyümüş biri gibi kalbim bölünüyor. Duvara yansıyan ışığın yaptığı kelimeler. O kelimeler uykuda geldiği için belki de hala dönüyorlar etrafımda. Bana dağları anlatıyorlar. İnanmanın kanıyla ayakta duran dağları. Çünkü bir sabahtır sonunda bizi uyandıracak olan, elimizden alınmış dünya ve doğumla bir dağ yolunda ilerlerken sen, bacası tüten bir ev, sulardan geçip gitmekte olan renk, anlatmaz yine de olanı, bize konuşanı kimdir? Çünkü tarih açmıştır yaraları bir kez. Öfkenin bağladığı kabuklar incelmiştir çoktan. Artık yalnızca sese sığınıyoruz, ışıklı geceye. Kime gideceğiz? Hangi sözle anlatacağız acıyı? Hangi dilde bağışlanmayı dileyeceğiz? Bize saf bir başlangıç gerekti. Kelimelerin gün doğumunda ruha bağlandığı bir başlangıç. Bize bir yuvanın şefkati gerekti. Kıyısından geçerken bacası tüten bir ev ki affetmenin toprağında sığınılacak bir yurt zannedi. Susalım. Susalım.
Growing up in two dreams. When you talk about sleep like someone who grew up in two dreams, my heart splits. The light reflected on the wall makes words, perhaps while I slept they appear, still swirling around me. Mountains, they say, the mountains stand still with the blood of the leaf. because it's morning after all, little shake is awake. Earth and our birthright have been stolen. You walk a mountain road, a house with a smoking chimney, like colour dispersing in water, doesn't tell the truth. The one speaking to us is still invisible. Who is it? History has already opened these wounds, fragile the scars, thicker with anger. Our voices are the only shelter in the lit night. Who can we talk to? What words can we use to speak of pain? In what language can we ask to be forgiven? We need a clean slate, a sunrise of words, dawn of the soul. We need the gentle home with chimney smoking, to walk by its walls on forgiving soil. We decide this is somewhere we can take refuge and fall quiet.
Thank you, şimdiden bir dağa bağlayacağım umudumu. Çünkü karşılaşmadır o, ihtimaldir. O dağda çocukluğun aklı, şefkati gizlenmiş. Bilmiyorum nerede bırakıldı gülüşüm ve nerede yarım kalan bakışım. Yarı gömülmüş bedenim anlatıyor bana sürmekte olanı. Çünkü geriye bakmakla ben incindim. Bana genç verilmiş bir gerçek bu. Bir karşılaşmanın vereceği son şey, ekinleri hatırlıyorum, kesildiklerinde diz olmayı gösteren buğdayları. Tabaklar kıpırdıyordu o gün, bütün sevinçleri havalandıran bir bahardı. Ne konuştuk bilmiyorum ama biliyorum, söylenmeyeni. Söylenmeyen, kabakların ışıltısında kaybolup gidendi, kanımızda kıpırdayan da söylenmeyen. Ama öyle geç, öyle geç ki artık o dağ yürüsem de yok. Ne gece, ne ateş. Beklemek de yok aramızda. Bir dağ var sadece.
I know the unspoken. Now all my hope is invested in the mountain. It harbors possibility, maybe an encounter. Maybe childhood's delicate soul is hidden on that mountain. I don't know where your smile lies abandoned or your unfinished stare. Your half-buried body betrays what has been done. Harm befell me when I looked back. I grasped the truth, the encounter's last gift to me. Remember harvest time. Wheat as it fell to the blade, showing the world who we are. The poplar shivered that day, the air lifted with the joys of spring. I don't know what we talked about, but I know it was unspoken. It went astray in the rustling poplars. It was moving in our blood, the unspoken. But it's too late, so late, that I will find no one, even if no night between us, nor fire, nor waiting. There is only a mountain.
Çocuk mezarları. Öldük işte. Haydır karanlıktan. Ayın ağaçları da gördü. Ufak taşlar da. Gece ve yıldızlar geçti üzerimizden. Ömür tükürtmesine.
Graves of children. So we died. We flitted out of darkness. Beaches bore witness, as did the tiniest of stones. Night and stars streamed above us, where we lay buried along the road.
Bahar yok. Er ulanlar açmış, yastayız yine. Bahar yok, ülke yok. Ve her yer kan içinde.
There is no spring. The Judas trees are blossoming. We're in mourning again. There is no spring. The fertile land is drowning in blood.
Saroyan Na'au. This poem is about Saroyan. Saroyan is one of the Armenian writers who born in America, in California. His ancestors were, after the genocide, they were deported from Turkey, and he grew up with the stories from about Anatolia, the days they used to live. And when he was in his late 60s, maybe 70s, I don't remember now, he wanted to go back to his hometown, his father's hometown, Bitlis. It's called Bitlis, it's in southeast. And this odyssey of Saroyan, he was with Ara Güler, one of the photographers, and Fikret Otyan, one of the painters and journalists that time. And they had a very, they hired a car, and then they had a very, very emotional, full of emotion, their journey is full of emotion. And Ara Güler took the photos, and Fikret Otyan helped him to him to feel at home, actually. Anyway, on the way to Bitlis, there is a city called Erzurum. In Erzurum, they had a small grave, little grave. He's thirsty, he wants to drink something, and on the roadside, there is a little boy. He's selling ayran. We call it ayran, it's with yogurt. You put water in it, and then for summer, for summertime, it's the best drink, actually. And he drank, and then he looked for the small money to give him. And his pockets has nothing in it. He has no money. And he got panicked. He says, "I don't have money." And the little boy, he looked at him. He says, "Never mind. You will pay later." And he sits and cries. I think this later, it's a summary of all our history, I think. There is a beautiful book published by Aras Publishing House in Turkey, one of the Armenian publishing houses. When I read this book, I was really crying. And this poem came after this. Saroyan'a ağıt. Bitlis'in dağları kar içinde. Dağları Bitlis'in ağa. Geçmişim. Bir adamın yurdunu ararken bulduğu taşlar, taş mıdır sadece? Yaz içinde bir kadın bir gömleği taşıyor. Acıdan bir gömleği anlatıyor size. Bakın diyor dağlar hala soğuk. Bakın kartallar, geyikler ve meşe. Biz unutmadık. Göğsünde bir yastan kalan kederle yakıştın gecenize. Yakıştın toprakta büyüyen yalnızlığa. Senin dönüşüne bakıyorum ben. Bitlis'in dağlarına. Bir babanın kanlı başını süsleyen güllerin solmadığı zamana. Bakıyorum inatla. Ve biliyorum. Aynı kelimeler, aynı yerden söylense de aynı dağları, aynı vadileri anlatmaz. Ve nehri özleminin aynı uzaklığa ulaşmaz. Şimdi bir müziğin her şeyi yenilediği bu sabah, bir adamın bir taşın karşısında oturmasıdır geçmiş. Harfleri okunmayan, kırık bütün kalpler gibi acı içinde bir taş. Ceplerine taş dolduran adamı hatırladın mı? Bir yurt arayan üzgün adamı. Onun yaslandığı duvar, onun bıraktığı rüzgar. Taş toplamaktadır hala bellekte, bellekte taş sökmektedir. Çünkü önünden daha büyük bir yol var önümüzde. Artık karları bağışlıyorum. que estou pequena sobre o bicho alto. Quero chegar.
Requiem for Sauron. The mountains of Bitlis are covered in snow. The mountains of Bitlis own the past. The man looking for his homeland. Are the stones he finds just stones? A woman in mourning is carrying a shirt. She tells us the shirt is filled with pain. Look, she says, in the mountains it's still cold. Look, eagles, oak trees, and deer. We won't forget. With the grief from her lament still lingering in your breast, you belong in our night. You belong in the loneliness growing in our soil. I watch for your return to the mountains of Beacons. Stubbornly, I look to the time when the roses that dress a father's little head don't fade. And I know we can't use the same words to speak of the same mountains, and the river of longing will never attain the same valleys. This morning, one music renews everything. History is a man sitting in front of a shattered stone. Indecipherable, and like all broken hearts, a stone in pain. Do you remember the man filling his pockets with stones, the desolate man searching for his homeland? He's leaning on the wall, he's looking at the wind. When we remember him, he's still gathering stones. When we remember him, he's still dismantling stones. Because there lies ahead of us a journey greater than death, now I forgive the snows, that departure, the last breath stolen by the wind, the last breath stolen by winter. Now I forgive everything.
And the last one, in Turkish, I was surprised. I'm going to read one of my Kurdish poems for the first time in love. This is Lalesh. So Lalesh is the city which is in Mount Sinjar in Iraq, Iraq Kurdistan. It's the holy place of the Yazidis. I've been there. And when I was there, I felt very much at home because the ritual they have, they believe, we have same motives actually. I come from an Alevi family. My mom always prayed for sun, for fire. There is something very similar. And there is a secret. It's in poem, but it was a real secret. I'm not gonna tell you, it is a secret, because yeah, I felt at home there, and during my visit, I write this poem there, when I was there. I just had a small break, and then I went to a corner, I was crying and writing, and they were looking at me, and it was, yeah, one of the poems. Lalesh. Bu güneştir, bu da ev. Meleğin kuruduğu yuva bekler hep. Diyor ki bana, eşiklerden geçerek gör siyah olanı, insanlığı kurtaranı gör. Hani o yükseklikten, dağların insanı koruyan bakarından söz eden, başlıyorum düğümlerden, kumaşların bebeklerle mühürlendiği karanlıktan başlıyorum. Ve batıyor güneşimiz bizim, herkesten önce. Çocukların vaftizi badem ağaçlarına asılmış dilek. Bahar geldi ve gidişim senin hiç bitmedi. Bana diyor ki, gözyaşlarının soğukluğunu kapıda bırak. O bizim borcumuzdur. Unutma diyor, evin bu dağların yanı. Seni inananların sabahında en önde ağırlayacağız. kızıl kaliteler içinde badem ağaçlarına ve taşlara sunarak ve bilerek hangi acı karartmamış yürekleri. Ben gizli bir inanandım ve gizli kaldım. Sırrım çözüldü ve o dağın kovuğunda bulduğum acıdan saadet ve benzerliğim onlara, evet yuvayadır dönüş ve yuva dağların arasında unutulmuş badem ağaçları ve düğümlerdir.
This is the sun, and I'm home. The nest the peacock angel protects, waiting faithfully. The man tells me, look, see the black one who hovers on the thresholds. See the one who can save humanity. He tells how human dignity was preserved by the height of these mountains. He says, our son is the first to step. The baptism of children is a wish hung on almond trees. I start on the knots. I begin in the dark, untying wishes sealed in development. Spring has come, and your departure is never ending. He tells me, leave your cold tears at the door. This is our burden. Don't forget, you belong here by the mountains. In the morning, we will welcome you, making offerings to almond trees and stones, in scarlet velvet hearts undimmed by pain. They recognize me, a secret believer. I found calm soil in the mountains then. And yes, I will come home to the almond trees and those knots, forgotten. Kurdish sound, how it sounds. That's why, that was my first feeling. And then I was off to New York on the plane. I usually travel, I write. It just comes. Usually poetry, it comes. I don't prepare anything. If I have pen and notebook, and then poetry is work. Otherwise, it flew away, it's like a music. And the music came in Kurdish, and then I made some notes. On the way back, I told my mom, I said, Mom, do you know I'm writing in Kurdish too? She said, you look at me in a very strange way. She couldn't believe, I think. And she said, can you read it to me? And I read. One of the poems, it's called Chaspa.
say, when you say chakpa, do you mean turn around you, or you call someone to came back, to return? I said, I'm calling someone to return. And she said, then it's begere, it's not chakpa. She's not my editor. Mother. It's writing in Kurdish, it's like being complete, going home, going back home. And it's very, it feels very different for me. And my Kurdish is very weak compared to my Turkish. And the things I write is more like haiku. My vocabulary is very limited. Because I come from the skirt of Kurdistan, we are from Marash. I think there are some Marash people, they will understand. I insist to write in Marash local dialect, actually. But then my intellectual Kurdish friends, they were like, okay, we cannot understand, that's why you have to work on it. We can help you for the editing. Anyway, they helped me for the little things, but still I keep my local Kurdish here because our Kurdish is like Swiss German. It's like mountain, like more. They say herevere, they say karavara. It's like Anyway, I'm going to read 2 points, short ones. First is ba. Ba is a
wind.
Ba is ra vile dechel. Ciai în dur. Ția să ta nebunime, e drește vă, toată mare mână. De rimini becurie, de lemini becurie, herpiște de chibatime, ez de lumhepati, de serecha, de desecha, de ceabecha, ez de lumhepati ba, hepat. And Chakpa, my mom came to Begere. Daki mene da be, Chakpa, Chakpa, Chakpa, verende men. Daki mene da be, Mara, Mara, Mara dur, Chia, Kijifurun. Durske tiyed lema, le chiyayen men,